أيا طالب العلم قم لا تنم فإن الزمان انقضى.
أيا طالب العلم قم لا تنم فإن الزمان انقضى وانصرم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، we're going to start with the kitab تعظيم العلم written by the great Shaykh صالح ابن عبد الله ابن حمد العصيمي حفظه الله تبارك وتعالى ورعاه. The kitab, it talks about the manners and the etiquettes of the student of knowledge, and the Shaykh, he categorized the kitab into 20 points. So inshallah ta'ala, without any further ado, we're going to start bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. The author rahimahullah, Shaykh Salih ibn Abdullah ibn Hamad al-Usaymi, he started the kitab with a muqaddimah. First of all, he did at the beginning of his muqaddimah 4 things which are referred to and it's seen as adabu tasnif, the manners of authorship. If you want to author something, there are 4 manners that you need to follow in the introduction of your authorship. The first one is, you have to start with the basmala. So you say bismillahi. The second is alhamdala. So you say alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, which the author did, which is the second. And the third, which is, that the author rahimahullah did, is ash-shahadatu lillahi bil wahdaniyya, testifying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in oneness, in worship subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wali Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bir risala, and also testifying that Nabiullah Muhammad is a messenger sent from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, what we have to understand is Nabiullah Muhammad, his level is not as high as the level of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he's a slave, he's not someone we worship. He is a abd, he's a slave. But he's also not an ordinary slave. He is a rasul, he's a messenger. And so we combine between those two by saying he is abdun, a slave, فلا يعبد, ورسول فلا يكذب. He is a slave, so he's not worshipped. Okay? And he's also a messenger, he's not disbelieved in. ولكن يطاع ويتبع. Rather, he is followed and adhered to, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also, the fourth one is wassalatu ala an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sending salutation on the messenger alayhi salatu wa sallam. We consider the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or what we do for the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, is that we send salutation on him alayhi salatu wa sallam. The word as-salah, the strongest opinion is salah means ثَنَاءُ اللَّهِ فِي الْمَلَأِ الْأَعْلَى. Allah praises the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the high station with the angels. Allah praises the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the word salah does not mean rahmah. It doesn't mean rahmah, as some scholars have taken that opinion. The reason for why it's not a rahmah is because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi Allah azza wa jalla in the Quran, he combined between salah and rahmah in the Quran. Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ. So if salah and rahmah were the same, Allah would not have mentioned them together. And that's what the scholars took from that. And Ibn al-Qayyim, he wrote a kitab called جَلَاءُ الْأَفْهَامِ فِي فَضْلِ الصَّلَاةِ عَلَىٰ خَيْرِ الْأَنَامِ, where he spoke about this issue and he discussed it in great details. رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ رَحْمَةً وَاسِعَةً, that the word as-salah means sana'ullah. Allah is praising the Prophet. And it does not in any way, shape or form mean ar-rahmah. And this is the view of Abu Aliya al-Rayahi, in which Al-Imam al-Bukhari mentions it in his Sahih Mu'allaqan bi Siqat al-Jazmi. Then the Shaykh rahimahullah, after talking about the adab al-tasnif, the manners of authorship, the Shaykh rahimahullah, he went into informing us about the intent of why he's written this book. And the reason why the author rahimahullah wrote this book is to show the students of knowledge and the people who love knowledge and are passionate about knowledge, that knowledge cannot be gained unless we venerate it and we glorify it. Knowledge requires from us ta'zim, glorification. And the Shaykh rahimahullah, he took this name ta'zimul ilm from none other than the great scholar Abu Muhammad al-Darimi, who has a kitab called Al-Musnad al-Jami'. In there there's a chapter which is known as Kitab al-Ilm. And in there there's a bab where it's called Babu I'zam al-Ilm, venerating and glorifying knowledge. Then Sheikh Saleh ibn Abdullah ibn Hamad al-Usaymi, he took it from this great scholar Abu Muhammad al-Darimi rahimahullah. And so inshallah ta'ala, these 20 chapters, the Shaykh, what he points out is these 20 chapters, some people whose aspiration is very low and they don't have high aspiration. Some people don't have aspiration. And so when they look at these 20 chapters, I mean, these 20 points, they will say, is it possible for anyone to achieve these 20 things? Some people are going to say that. So the Shaykh rahimahullah, he said these people are people whose aspiration is very low. ضَعُفَتْ نُفُوسُهُمْ, their nafs is very weak. So they claim that these are extreme and these are things that are not going to be possible to take place, that these things can't happen. And they consider this to be غُلُوٌ وَتَنَطُعٌ and تَشَدُّدٌ غَيْرَ مُقْنِعٍ. This is extremism. Are you seriously saying that there are people who actually did all of these 20? But then the Shaykh rahimahullah, he said, these people ضُرِبَ بَيْنَهُمْ وَبَيْنَهَا بِسُورٍ لَهُ بَابٌ بَاطِنُهُ فِيهِ الرَّحْمَةِ وَظَاهِرُهُ مِنْ قِبَلِهِ الْعَذَابِ. These people, the reality and the truth has been blocked from them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never allowed them to truly understand the value and the importance of these 20 points. Brothers and sisters, inshallah ta'ala, our aim and objective is to take these 20 points and live by it, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ الْكَرِيمِ. As the poet said, إِن لَمْ تَكُونُوا مِثْلَهُمْ فَتَشَبَّهُوا إِنَّ التَّشَبُّهَا بِالْكِرَامِ فَلَاحُ. If you can't be like them, then try to imitate them. For verily, imitating the righteous people itself is a virtue. كَمَالُ الْعَقْلِ عُلُوُّ الْهِمَّةِ وَالرَّاضِي بِالدُّونِ دَنِي. High aspiration is an indication that you're smart and you're clever. And if you're pleased with the bare minimum, it shows that you're dim-witted. So inshallah ta'ala, let's listen to these 20 points and inshallah ta'ala, try to apply it in our life. And these 20 inshallah ta'ala, I can reassure all of you that it's not only going to benefit the student of knowledge who's seeking Islamic knowledge, it will also benefit anyone who's trying to seek even academic, secular knowledge as well. They can benefit from it because it talks about important methods of how to seek knowledge. Inshallah ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, before we go into the 20 points, I want to say that anyone who wants to attain Islamic knowledge, there are two important things that have to be present. If you want to seek knowledge and you want to attain the knowledge of the religion, there are two important things that you need to understand. The first thing is a methodology in how to seek knowledge. And this kitab, inshallah ta'ala, will explain that bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. A methodology, a manhajiyya to seek knowledge. Knowledge, brothers and sisters, is not just get a book and pick it up and read it. It is a methodology, and there is a way to seek knowledge, and there's a way to go about it. So that's the first thing, inshallah ta'ala. If you want to attain knowledge, you have to know the methodology and the way to seek knowledge. The second one is, you have to understand the characteristics and the attributes that the student of knowledge must adorn himself with. Yes, there are characteristics that you need to come with in order to attain the Islamic knowledge, inshallah ta'ala. So bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, without any further ado, we're going to now go through these 20 points, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. Pay attention with me, inshallah ta'ala, as we reap from this book, and we take from this book the benefits and the gems and the jewels that are in it, inshallah ta'ala. Naam. The author, rahimahullah, the first chapter, he talks about purifying the heart, tatiru wi'a'il ilm, which means المحل الذي يحفظ فيه العلم, the place where the knowledge is going to be in, inshallah ta'ala. My beloved brothers and sisters, if you want to drink a water, you have to make sure that the cup that you're going to pour that water into is clean. And if you want to pour knowledge into your heart, and that's where the knowledge goes into, then you have to make sure that your heart is clean. That's where the knowledge, inshallah ta'ala, will stay in. And the knowledge settles and it comes out from a pure and a clean heart. If the heart is filthy, then we can imagine a water, if it's poured in a filthy cup, what will happen to that water? It won't taste pure, will it? Then the same would be the knowledge. If the knowledge is poured into the heart and the heart is tainted and it's filthy, then the effects that knowledge will have on the heart is very low. It won't change you. So cleansing and cleaning your heart and purifying your heart And there are two types of filth that your heart can go through. The first one is najasatu ash-shubuhat and najasatu shahawat. There are two types of filth and dirt in which your heart can go through. And they are doubts and desires. Doubts and desires. And the doubts are two types. The doubt in which the heart can suffer from, or it can harm the heart, or it can taint the heart, or can make the heart impure, are two. The first one is doubts. And the doubts are two types. Shubuhat are two types. The first one is al-kufru, disbelief of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second one is al-bid'ah, innovation. Those are two najasa. Najasa to shirk am a kufr, and the najasa of bid'ah. And both of them are shubuhat, doubts. And the second type in which your heart can suffer from is shahawat, desires. And the desires are also two types. They are major sins and minor sins. Major sins and minor sins. So the person needs to purify his heart. وَلِذَلِكَ the author rahimahullah, he gave an evidence for it. He brought the ayah in Surah Al-Mudathir where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, وَثِيَابَكَ فَطَهِرْ. And the word ثِيَابَكَ, there are three tafsir in what is meant by ثِيَابَكَ. The first view is ثِيَابَكَ means رِدَاءَكَ, your garment, purify it. The second view in ثِيَابَكَ is قَلْبَكَ فَطَهِرْ. And the third view regarding وَثِيَابَكَ فَطَهِرْ means عَمَلَكَ فَطَهِرْ. And all of those are three are used in the Arabic language. Imrul Qais mentioned the heart. He said, فَسُلِّي ثِيَابَكَ مِنْ ثِيَابَكِ وَانْسِلِي. Purify from my heart the love I have for you. Imrul Qais is talking one of the Mu'allaqat al-Ashara. Then the word ثِيَاب can also mean the heart. Okay, it can also mean the heart. And that's what the author rahimahullah is choosing it for here now, which is وَثِيَابَكَ أَيْ وَقَلْبَكَ فَطَهِرْ. So that would mean when Nabi Muhammad was told to go out and give da'wah, the thing that he was told to purify was what? His heart. Allah said to him, قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ وَثِيَابَكَ أَيْشْ فَطَهِرْ. Purify your heart. The second evidence that the author rahimahullah brought is the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ in Sahih Muslim, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Inna Allah la yanzuru ila ajsamikum wala ila suwarikum, walakin yanzuru ila qulubikum wa a'malikum." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he does not look at your physique. Okay? Allah doesn't look at your body and he doesn't look at your physique. Inna Allah la yanzuru ila ajsamikum wala ila suwarikum. Allah doesn't look at it. Walakin yanzuru ila qulubikum wa a'malikum. Allah looks at your heart and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala looks at your actions. So the person should know that the thing Allah is looking at is your heart. And the heart has to be taken care of. Because وَكُلُّ إِنَاءٍ بِالَّذِي فِيهِ يَنْضَحُ وَكُلُّ إِنَاءٍ بِالَّذِي فِيهِ يَنْضَحُ. Every vessel only sweats what's inside it. So if your heart is good, then what's going to come out of it, inshallah ta'ala, is going to be good actions. The Prophet said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ الْحَلَالَ بَيِّنٌ وَإِنَّ الْحَرَامَ بَيِّنٌ وَبَيْنَهُمَا أُمُورٌ مُشْتَبِهَاتٌ لَا يَعْلَمُهُنَّ كَثِيرٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ فَمَنِ اتَّقَى الشُّبُهَاتِ فَقَدْ اسْتَبْرَأَ لِدِينِ وَعِرْضِ وَمَنْ وَقَعَ فِي الشُّبُهَاتِ وَقَعَ فِي الْحَرَامِ كَالرَّاعِ يَرْعَى حَوْلَ الْحِمَى يُوشِكُ أَنْ يَرْتَعَ فِيهِ أَلَا وَإِنَّ لِكُلِّ مَلِكٍ حِمَى أَلَا وَإِنَّ حِمَى اللَّهِ مَحَارِمُهُ أَلَا وَإِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَةً إِذَا صَلَحَتْ صَلَحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبُ. There is a vessel inside the human body. There's a morsel inside the human body. A piece of meat inside the human body. إِذَا صَلَحَتْ, if it's good, صَلَحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ, the whole entire body is good. وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ, and if it's corrupt, the whole entire heart is, the whole entire body is going to be corrupt. And the Prophet said to us, عليه الصلاة والسلام, it is the heart. Okay, so we have to make sure that we cleanse our heart. And Ibn al-Qayyim, he mentions in his Nuniyah, he said, وَحْذَرْ كَمَائِنَ نَفْسِكَ اللَّاتِ, he said, be careful about the hidden defect in which the heart can suffer from. مَتَى خَرَجَتْ كُسِرْتَ كَسْرَ مُهَانٍ. And when this hidden defect comes out, It's going to destroy you. It's going to what? Destroy you. And this is something that many of us are heedless about. That there is a hidden najasa in our hearts. We think we've cleansed it, but really the truth is that we haven't cleansed it. So it starts to come out later. As we seek knowledge, we start to see these bad traits coming out. ولذلك سهل بن عبد الله التستري he said حرام على قلب أن يدخله النور وفيه شيء مما يكرهه الله. It's haram for knowledge to enter the heart. حرام على قلب أن يدخله النور. It's haram for knowledge to enter the heart of a person, and inside this heart there is something Allah dislikes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, if there is in your heart filth and dirt, knowledge will not enter your heart. In order for knowledge to enter your heart, make sure that you come with what? A clean heart. ولذلك الشافعي he said شكوت إلى وكيع بسوء حفظي فأرشدني إلى ترك المعاصي وقال إن العلم نور ونور الله لا يهدى لعاصي. وكيع من الجراح الرؤاسي who is the sheikh of الإمام الشافعي محمد بن إدريس الشافعي. شافعي said I complained to my teacher وكيع and I told him شكوت إلى وكيع بسوء حفظي. I said I can't memorize, my memorization is bad, I want to be good at memorizing, what should I do? فأرشدني إلى ترك المعاصي. He said to me, don't do anything haram, don't lie, don't be evil towards your mom and bad, do good. يعني كن صالحا, good, be righteous, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let the knowledge enter your heart. Because knowledge does not enter the heart of a heart that is preoccupied with sins. So that's the important point that we have to understand. ولذلك Allah said in the Quran, سأصرف عن آياتي الذين يتكبرون في الأرض بغير الحق. Allah said subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm going to divert my verses from the people who are arrogant. Sufyan al-Thawri, he said, what it means, سأصرف عن آياتي الذين يتكبرون في الأرض بغير الحق means, سأصرفهم عن فهم القرآن. Allah is going to divert them from the understanding of the Quran. They won't be able to understand the Quran. They are going to be like the people. مثل الذين حملوا التوراة ثم لم يحملوها كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا. They're going to be memorizing the wordings of the Quran, but they won't understand it. So in order for them to inshallah ta'ala attain the knowledge, it means that they've taken the wordings with its meaning. And both of that will only come for a people who've cleansed their heart. Cleansed it from animosity. وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ إِخْوَانًا عَلَى سُرُرٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ. They don't have animosity and hate in their hearts. Their hearts are clean and pure. They don't have ulterior motives, hidden agendas. They are sincere, مُخْلِصِينَ لِلَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. So those are the people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to pour knowledge into their heart. So the first point is clean your heart.